why. But for now, this video is about the beginning of my landscape project and staying with the stone wall thing. I have built granite walls before. I have done paver stones in hardscaping or landscaping around people's houses. And this is about a raw antique granite stone wall.
Hey guys, John Rock and TV1 here.
So I am sitting out in my backyard on our little over 30 acres out here in southern New Hampshire. And all around me and behind me is granite. We are the granite state here in New Hampshire. We are also in southern New Hampshire, or the state of New Hampshire, one of the, one of the smallest states with the most amount of miles of stone wall. Granite stone walls in New England are prominent everywhere. They are on probably everybody's property out here, unless you live in the city somewhere, or a development, what do you want to call it? Granite stone walls, the history of granite stone walls as well goes way back before my time. It was considered the right thing to do. Right up through history, as far as, you know, being a landowner or a farmer or, you know, even a servant to the king back in the old days, which what this whole neighborhood is about. And I can't tell you where I live because I just can't have everybody showing up around here. But I can say I am in southern New Hampshire, and we live in a spot that is actually a closed gravel pit. But in its past, it had been used by the local people and the king for granite, for building foundations and walls and roads and pretty much anything else that, you know, the, I want to say colonials had used granite for. So, over the years, this particular piece of property had been closed by the town. It was a granite, granite quarry. Then it was a sand pit. Then guys were logging out of here. And then the town closed it back in the late 1800s. And so then it changed hands a few different times, and guys still tried to mine the granite and the sand out of here, and evidently the kibosh got put on that. And there's good reason for it, and in the future I will show you why. But for now, this video is about the beginning of my landscape project and staying with the stone wall thing. I have built granite walls before. I have done paver stones in hardscaping or landscaping around people's houses. And this is about a raw antique granite stone wall. So let me just show you a little bit. Okay, we're just gonna look at a small portion here. And last year I put up a video about my little custom 7 tractor hauling rocks around. And somebody left a comment about how do you work with rocks that big, and it looks like I'm just driving them around the yard. Well, how long does it take? Well, I can say that on just this 30 something acres that are out here, there's probably 3 to 4 miles of stone wall on this property. And you can see it out here, and it runs all the way around. There's my pool. You guys been watching them videos. And all the way down there and all the way around there. And of course it does all the perimeters, the property lines. And up out in the woods, which you guys probably can't see because I'm still trying to chop some of the stuff out of here. Last year we moved some of the rocks for this wall out of here. And the reason was that you could tell that they had been placed by somebody with a machine. They were not the right color. They were like this here rock dug out of the ground, you could tell. And up this hill is an old skidder trail. And so of course I'm trying to open that up so that I can, take rides out with the tractors up in there and have an easier time getting my firewood out. So that is what the point of me showing you out through the woods here. All out through this woods, and I mean a half a mile out in through there, where you would not want to carry a stone for your stone wall, is rocks that were split with feathers and wedges and hand drills. And that is a lot of work, but that is how it was done. So let me show you my project that I have going on. So here I am at the spot where I started this project last year. And we're at the front of my house, and you guys can see if you've been watching my videos, I was able to get my front yard to go green, even after all the weather. But the real gig here is we live this hillside, which probably isn't evident by the slope that's out. It is a slope. It's a serious slope. And in the last year since we've been here, we probably lost 100 yards of soil off the front yard due to erosion. Brand new house, finished in December, and we couldn't get anything to grow out here until the next year. By then, we already lost all the dirt. So at this point, you guys have been watching. I've been slowly trying to put it back. And this is the project that I started a year ago. And you will see custom 7 building a granite stone wall, you can see the start of this project. So I'll just show you where I've got.
We're holding by hand now. So yeah. All right. So here's my front yard and here is the front of my house. And of course it's hard to see, but I've been doing everything with my little Sears tractors and that plow dozer blade that Sears call it. And in the first video, I showed you that this had not been built. This is going to be what my new little trail road is so I can stay off my grass. But I cut a slot basically in the ground with the plow from that tractor and a shovel, and I have just started dropping those rocks in. And just like the rock walls that you saw out back, they are just placed, and mine are liable to be a bit more strategically placed because I'd like it to be, you know, a less of a rubble pile and more of a wall. And now it's not going to be a huge retaining wall. It only has to hold back maybe 18 inches of soil. And it's not finished, but things like this, and not this one because it's only going to wrap around maybe 100 feet or so. But the walls that you guys are seeing out back of my house here, and pretty much anywhere else, they took lifetimes to build. Generations of families used to live on the same spots. On the same property, and it was considered the right thing to do to build the walls, just like it was considered the right thing to do to grow pine trees and mill the boards off and send them over to your local church or something, you know, and help the town build the town hall and whatever. As a matter of fact, that's how they used to collect taxes in the old days. You could bring in your 12 shillings, or you could bring us a stack of pine boards, whatever you want to do. And that's how they collected taxes in the old days. And you could spend your time building the town meeting house. And you could bring some granite with you if you had some. And all of those things would eliminate your tax bill. So there were reasons for stone walls to get built. My reason is aesthetically pleasing. And we'll call this is hardscaping, some people call it. I mean, to me, it's just landscaping. But these boulders, this wall will eventually be about 3.5 feet tall, and in behind it I will fill in with some proper soil so that my better half can do some good planting and she'll have decent soil to grow out of. This is not this wall here is not meant to keep people out or to keep people in or animals of anything of the sort, and it doesn't have to retain or hold back a giant hillside. It's only going to be about 18 inches of soil behind it, so I can just show you here that you know, what I'm doing is piling the stones and filling in with rubble behind it. If you guys have been watching these videos, you'll see that this all happened here in the last couple of weeks. I actually just got this going on here. I got so many projects to do that, like I said, this wall will be a couple of years in the making. It actually took me most of last summer to collect my firewood and these stones on my little trailer there from around the yard and drop them on a pile back there. You know, a little bit up the ways from the hillside. And then I just, as I dig my spots and I roll the stones in, I use pry bars and, you know, if I have to, I will cut down a tree, a sapling to use for a long, long pry bar. And I use chipping hammers to sometimes pick a corner off and make something sit flat. And that is just how it's done. So for that guy out there in California who gave me the thumbs down on my last year's video that he's in the, remodeling business and he wants to go into landscaping, but he's retired and he needs to know how long it takes to build a wall like this. Well, a lifetime, bud. That's how long it takes. It takes lifetimes to build walls like that. It's that simple. Generations. Bring your kids. You know, bring them up so that they know what they're doing, and then you too can have stone walls like this out on your yard. These are not pre-manufactured squares. They never will be pre-manufactured squares. If you want a square, you'll have to chisel it, dig it, and drill it out yourself. That's how it's done. Or you can buy paver stones and put paver stone walkway and paver stone walls together. And some guys will do that because it's real easy to stack them and real easy to make them look square and neat and all that. But this kind of wall fits with the rest of my landscape. So anyways, you guys, it's not quite part one of this video. And I'll let you guys over time see this as I build this. But it is going to take a while. And that's just it. It's not the only thing that I do during the day. And it certainly won't be the only thing that I have, the only chore that I have to do for the next couple of years, but it probably will take that long. I don't have any other equipment other than my Sears tractors. I don't have a backhoe with a thumb on it or an excavator or anything of the sort. I dig holes. If I have the rock is too big, I will dig a hole. I will build a sled. I have dragged them, pulled them, pushed them, and rolled them to the pile. So anybody who wants to know, keep those words in the back of your mind and go. John at Rockhead TV1 said that. Peace out.